Well, my daddy left home when I was three. Didn't leave very much to my ma and me except this old guitar and an empty bottle of booze. Now, I don't blame him because he run and hid, but the meanest thing that my daddy ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. He must have thought that it was quite a joke, and it got a lot of laughs from a lot of folks. Seems I had to fight my whole life through. Some gal would giggle and I'd turn red, and some guy'd laugh and I'd bust his head. I'll tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. But I grew up quick and I grew up mean. My fists got hard, my wits got keen. Roamed from town to town to hide my shame. But I made me a vow to the moon and stars and search the honky-tonks and bars. Kill that man and give me that awful name. Well, it was Gatlinburg in mid-July, and I just hit town and my throat was dry. Thought I'd stop and have myself a brew. At an old saloon on a street of mud, and there at a table dealing stud, sat the dirty mangy dog that named me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was my own sweet dad from a worn-out picture that my mother had had. Knew that scar on his cheek and his evil eye. He was big and bent and gray and old, and I looked at him and my blood ran cold, and I said, my name is Sue. How do you do? Now you're gonna die. Well, I told him, hit him hard right between the eyes, and he went down, but to my surprise, come up with a knife and cut off a piece of my ear. Then I busted the chair right across his teeth, and we crashed through the walls and into the street, kicking and gouging in the mud and the blood and the beer. Well, I'll tell you, I fought tougher men, but I really can't remember when. He kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. Heard him laugh and then I heard him cuss, and he reached for his gun, but I pulled mine first. He stood there looking at me and I saw him smile. He said, son, this world is rough, and if a man's gonna make it, he's gotta be tough. And I knew I wouldn't be there to help you along. So I give you that name and I said goodbye, and I knew you'd have to get tough or die. It's that name that'll help to make you strong. Said, now you just fought one hell of a fight, and I know you hate me and you got the right to kill me now, and I wouldn't blame you if you do. But you ought to thank me before I die for the gravel in your gut and the spit in your eye, cause I'm the son of a bitch that named you Sue. What could I do? What could I do? Well, I got all choked up and I threw down my gun. I called him my pa and he called me his son. Come away with a different point of view. And I think about it now and then, every time I try and every time I win. And if I ever have a boy, well, I had a boy and I named him John Carter, and he looks like his mother, but he's crazy about his daddy. Good time. What? What? How'd I cut my ear? So what'd you say? What'd he say? If you're going to speak up, get a microphone. Can't hear you up here. Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head that didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled in my closet, threw my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. Then I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I smoked my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs that I'd been picking. Then I lit my first and watched a small boy cussing at a can that he'd been kicking. I crossed the empty street, caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday that'll make your body feel alone. Oh, there ain't nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk Sunday morning coming down. In the park I saw Daddy with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And I stopped beside Sunday school, listened to the songs that they were singing. Bringing in the sheaves, then I headed down the road. Somewhere far away, a lonely bell was ringing. And it took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. Oh, there ain't nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk Sunday morning coming down. All right. Well, you wonder why I always dress in black. Why you never see bright colors on my back. You wonder why does my appearance seem to have a somber tone. Well, there's a reason for the things that I have on. I wear the black for the poor and the beaten down. Living in the hopeless, hungry side of town. I wear it for the prisoner who has long paid for his crime, but is there because he's a victim of the times. I wear the black for those who never read, nor listen to the words that Jesus said about that way to happiness through love and charity. I believe he's talking straight to you and me. Oh, we're doing mighty fine, I do suppose, in our streak of lightning cars and fancy clothes. But just so we're reminded of the ones who are held back, up front there ought to be a man in black. I wear it for the thousands who have died, believing that we all were on their side. I wear it for another 100,000 who have died, believing that God was on their side. Well, there's things that never will be right, I know, and things need changing anywhere you go. But till we start to make a move to make a few things right. You'll never see me wear a suit of white. Oh, I'd love to wear a rainbow every day and tell the world that everything's okay. But I'll try to carry off a little darkness on my back till things are brighter. I'm a man in black. All you fellas that are really trying, some of you might find yourself in the situation that I'm in right now. I'm just an old chunk of coal, but I'm hoping to be a diamond someday. I'm just an old chunk of coal, but I'm gonna be a diamond someday. I'm gonna kneel and pray till I'm so blue, pure, perfect. Gonna put a smile on everybody's face. Yes, now I'm gonna kneel and pray every day, lest I should become pain along the way. I'm just an old chunk of coal now, Lord, but I'm gonna be a diamond someday. Well, I'm gonna learn all the new words to talk. I'm gonna search and find a better way to walk. I'm gonna spit and polish my old rough-edged self till I get rid of every single flaw. Oh, I wanna be the world's best friend. Gonna go around shaking everybody's hand. I'm just an old chunk of coal now, Lord, but I'm gonna be a diamond someday. I'm just an old chunk of coal now, Lord, but I'm gonna be a diamond someday.
Like a child. Oh,
the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. Went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire. Hey, thank you very much. Thank you. You know, last night we had two concerts in Sacramento. We finished about 1 a.m., got 4 or 5 hours sleep, and came down to do two concerts here. And we continue on to Bakersfield, where we do a concert tonight. So you can say we are still on the move, even though I'm 48 next year, you know. I got a lot of friends my age who say, man, I feel 25. I feel 48. We came down to do this show for everybody. And there's a basketball going on over there, and we'd like to invite, we'd like to, for the fellas to decide whether they want to play basketball or come to show. Because we came for each and every one of you, no matter what race, creed, or color you are. And it's very distracting to us for other activities to be going on, you know, while we're trying to do a show for you. All right? Some people got no class? All right. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, Bob's not here. He couldn't. Bob couldn't come today. So we're going to keep the basketball game going, right, guards? Okay. All right. I'm going to do a cowboy song for you. All you cowboys out there. All right. June Carter is ill. She had dental surgery about 4 days ago. She's in bed. And she asked me to tell you what was wrong, really. She had her false teeth put on the caps, you know? And she was allergic to the epoxy they put them on with, and it burned all the skin off the inside of her mouth and part of her gums. And she's in bad shape, and June's got a big mouth, you know? I mean, it really hurts her a lot, but she's going to join us in a couple of days, and she said, tell you that she couldn't be here, and she wishes she could, but just because she couldn't be here, you're going to have more of me. Whatever that means. I ride an old pain, I lead an old dance. I'm off to Montana for to throw the hooligan, where they feed in the coolies, they water in the draw. Their tails are all matted, their backs are all raw. Ride around, little doggies, ride around slow. The fiery and snuffy are raring to go. Bill Jones had two daughters and a son. One went to Denver, the other went wrong. His young wife died in a Purim fight, but he tries to keep singing from morning to night. Ride around, little dogies, ride around slow. The fiery and snuffy are raring to go. When I die, take my saddle from the wall, strap it on my pony, lead him out of the stall, tie my bones hands on his back, turn our faces to the west, and we'll ride the ferries that we love the best. Ride around, little doggies, ride around slow. The fiery and snuffy are raring to go. As I walked out on the streets of Laredo, as I walked out on Laredo one day, I spied a young cowboy all wrapped in white linen, all wrapped in white linen, cold as the clay. I can see by your outfit that you are a cowboy. These words he did say as I boldly walked by. Come and sit down beside me and hear my sad story. I'm shot in the breast and I know I must die. Then beat the drum slowly, play the fife slowly, play the dead march as you carry me along. Take me to the green valley, lay the sod over me. I'm a young cowboy and oh, I've done wrong. Get six jolly cowboys to carry my coffin, six pretty maidens to bear up my paw, throw bunches of roses all over my coffin, roses to deaden the clods as they fall. Then beat the drum slowly, play the fife slowly, play the dead march as you carry me along. Take me to the green valley, lay the sod over me. I'm a young cowboy and know I've done wrong. Riding out one dark and windy day, up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way, when all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged sky, and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky, for he saw the riders coming hard and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-i-oh! Yippee-yay! Ghost riders in the sky. Faces gaunt, their eyes were blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught him yet. 'Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky, on horses smart and fire. As they ride on, hear their cry. cry. As the rider sloped on by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell of riding on our range, then cowboy, change your ways. Today are with us, you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-yi-oh, yippee-yi-oh, coldest riders in the sky, coldest riders in the sky. Guys, all these fellas donated their services to come down here today. We donated all our time and services, what, you know, whatever that's worth. It's I've been watching the basketball game. I don't think anybody's winning yet. The trumpet players have been with me just a couple of years. Jack Hale and Bob Lewin, the latest addition to our show. When we recorded Ring of Fire, we wanted trumpet players on our concerts so they'd sound like the records, you know, but they were only about 5 years old then. Their mother wouldn't let them go, so we had to wait a while. The Tennessee Three are one of the original Tennessee Two, Marshall Grant, 25 years with me. The man on the drums played drums on such great classics as Blue Suede Shoes, the original recording by Carl Perkins, and all of those great Sun rockabilly records, W.S. Holland. Been with us 23 years. My brother-in-law, who is married to my sister-in-law, Anita, June's sister, Anita, plays guitar, Bob Wooten. We'll hear from Cousin Jerry. And Bob, you want to sing a cowboy song? Come on, sing one. I gave him a Gene Autry guitar a long time ago. It was made in 1929. And he's got a collection of Gene Autry movies, and he knows all those songs. John Wesley Harden. I don't remember that one. Sorry. That's Bob Dylan's album. You like Bob Dylan? All right, I'll sing you a Bob Dylan song while Bob's getting ready. Okay, you like Bob Dylan? You got it. Huh? Down the street the dogs are barking and the day is getting dark. When the night begins to fall, then the dogs will lose the bark. I'll echo in the shadows and the silence of my mind. I'm just one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind. It's a restless, hungry feeling, and it does no one no good. And everything I'm saying, you could say it just as good. 'Cause you're right from your side, and I'm right from mine. We're both just one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind.
Come
Come sit by my side, little darling. Come lay your cool hand on my brow and promise me that you will never be nobody's darling but mine. Be nobody's darling but mine, love. Be honest, be faithful, be kind, and promise me that you will never be nobody's darling but mine. You're as sweet as the flowers of springtime. You're as pure as the dew from a rose. I'd rather be somebody's darling than a poor boy nobody knows. Nobody's darling but mine, love. Be honest, be faithful, be kind, and promise me that you will never be nobody's darling but mine. Goodbye. Goodbye, little darling. I'm leaving this old world behind. So promise me that you will never be nobody's darling but mine.
Kentucky back in 49, went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry. Always wanted me one that was long and black. Well, one day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now, getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. Gonna ride around in style, gonna drive everybody wild, 'cause I'll have the only one there is around. Well, the very next day when I checked in with my big lunchbox and help from my friends, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gears. I never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. Well, the first day I got me a fuel pump, the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, then I got me a transmission and all the chrome. Little things I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks. The big stuff I snuck out in my buddy's mobile home. Well, now, up to now, my plan went all right till we tried to put it all together one night. And that's when I noticed that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73. And when we tried to put in the bolts, all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little bit of help from an adapter kit, had that engine running just like a song. The headlights was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right, but when we pulled out the switch, all three of them come on. Well, the back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together, and when we got through, that's when I noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had a doubt. But she opened the door and said, "Honey, take me for a spin." So I spun her. Spin, spin. Yeah. Well, we went uptown just to get the tags, and I hit her to ride on down Main Drag. You could hear everybody laughing for blocks around. But up there at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, cause to type it up, it took the whole staff, and when they got through, the title weighed 60 pounds. I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. Gonna ride around in style, gonna drive everybody wild, cause I'll have the only one there is around. Oh, yeah, Red Rider, this is the Cottonmouth and the Psycho Billy Cadillac. Come on. Huh? Negatory on the cost there. I just went up to the factory to pick it up. It's cheaper that way. What model is it? Well, it's 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59 automobile. It's a 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66. Right now, I'd like you to hear the best piano player in Hickman County, Tennessee. No, I think he's the finest I ever heard. Earl Ball on the piano, ladies and gentlemen. You know, the first prison concert we did was Huntsville, Texas State Prison in 1957. 57, 23 years ago. And we had a record, a terrible place. Well, yeah, it was. Yeah. We did a show there. It was the only free concert we ever did. I mean, the only paid concert we ever did at the prison. It was for James Arness. He asked us to do the concert with him, and he paid us for it. But the word got around that we played Huntsville, and we got requests from all over. So January 1st, 1958, we played San Quentin the first time. A fellow named Merle Haggard was sitting on the front row, and he was paroled about 3 years later. We were there January 1st, 1959, 1960, 1961, 1962. Then we played Folsom, played Leavenworth, we played East Pennsylvania State Pen, and we played Arkansas State. state. We play Kansas, Leavenworth, the women's prison, as well as the men's. And we've done all this, and we've done it because we felt like that the fellas needed something. And if we did a concert at a prison, and we came and did it on our own, at our own expense, in our own time, then surely somebody out there would know that somebody out there cares, and we care. And we're not doing it for publicity, because I don't know if anybody knows, but we went back to San Quentin and Folsom last year and did another concert. And we've done other prison concerts that we haven't mentioned. And we did not allow press in at any of these concerts that we've done. So I just want you to know that we care for you, and that as human beings, that we're all of the human family, and that I hope to see a lot of you on the outside soon. Another reason I play prison is because I'm a Christian, and I'm told to visit the widows and the sick and the orphans and those in prison. Of course, some of you buy that, some don't, but that's all right with me. Basketball game's over. How about that? You know, if you were with us when we started at Sun Records in 1955, you might remember we sounded just a little bit like this. Tennessee tune, myself. Well, I taught the weeping willow how to cry, and I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears I cried for that woman are gonna flood you, big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota, and it tore me up every time I heard her drawl, southern drawl. Then I heard my dream went back downstream, cavorting in Davenport, and I followed you, big river, when you called. Then you took me to St. Louis, later on down the river. A freighter said she's been here, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found the trail in Memphis, but she just walked up the bluff. She raised a few eyebrows and went on down alone. Now won't you bat it down by Baton Rouge, River Queen, roll it on. Take that woman on down to New Orleans, New Orleans. Go on, I've had enough, dump my blues down in the gulf. She loves you, big river, more than me. Love you more than me, baby. Then you took me to St. Louis, later on down the river. A freighter said she's been here, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found the trail in Memphis, but she just walked up the bluff, raised a few eyebrows and went on down alone. Well, now I pulled into Natchez the next day down the river, but there wasn't much there to make around to stay very long. When I left, it was raining, so nobody saw me cry. Big river, why is she doing me this way? Yes, I taught the weeping willow how to cry, cry, cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears I cried for that woman gonna flood you, big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. On the jackets that you see some of the guys wearing says silver. That means we've been at it 25 years. It's our silver anniversary. We have a TV special on late April, an hour and a half show. There are 39 guest artists on the show. There's old Chris and old Waylon and Gatlin and I don't know who all. Tom T. Hall, everybody, all of our friends are. Willie, yeah, everybody's on it. The Statler Brothers, Oak Ridge Boys, all of them are. Barbara Mandrell, David Allen Coe, and Johnny Paycheck. What? That's what he said. Didn't know him till he was out, but he said I helped him get out. He said, he explained it later, he said it was the songs and the inspiration. I guess it must have come from my mama, though. Well, I'd like to sing a song for you from our Silver Anniversary album. And this is a song I wrote looking back about 15 years ago to how it was when I was bumming down in Greenwich Village with Dylan and Bob Dylan and Pete Seeger and a bunch of those guys, a bunch of folk singers down there, and I didn't know where I was. But I think it's good for a guy to look back on where he's been so he don't lose track of where he wants to go. And this is called Lonesome to the Bone. On the park bench I slept on, raindrops are falling on the newspapers covering me. I hear early morning motors, and I know the world is waking for the dawn. But my mind's down a dark alley, somewhere where last night you loved me. But in the early morning chill, my arms remember still. And I'm dropping like a stone, lonesome to the bone. The sun is roughly rising on the roofs of Stagger Town. The time for sweating poison out is just now coming round. That high flying last night is over with and gone, leaving me lonesome to the bone. I walk the way the wind blows, but any way the wind goes will be good enough for me. My mind is like that traffic jam, and I walk between the cars lost and alone. Your hot breath and your laughter keep flashing through my mind to warm me. But with the naked light of day, it'll soon fade away. And I'm going down alone, lonesome to the bone. The sun is roughly rising on the roofs of Stagger Town. The time for sweating poison out is just now coming round. That high flying last night is over with and gone, leaving me lonesome to the bone. June and I got married. She had two daughters, and I had four, and we had a little boy. I made us six, and we're tired. Our oldest two, Roseanne Cash and Carlene Carter, are doing real good. They're 25 years old now, and we're proud of them. They're doing really good in the music business. But there was a couple of years there that they were bringing home their songs and demonstration recordings and playing them real loud, because it was country rock, country rock and roll, and rolling rock, and country rock and middle of the road, and road, country rock. And I guess I got to feeling kind of a little left out, because I was writing my little songs and bringing them home too and singing them. And I wrote a song called I Will Rock and Roll With You If I Have To. Well, they used to call me Rockabilly. All of us ran through. When Elvis opened up the door, poop, bop, a lot, bam, boom. I didn't ever play much rock and roll, 'cause I've got so much country in my soul. Oh, but I'm a different man from loving you. And I'd take a shot at what you ask me to. Baby, I will rock and roll with you if I have to. Memphis 1955 on Union Avenue. Charlie, Jerry, Carl, and Roy, and Billy Riley, too. A new sun rising on the way we sing. But a world of weirdos waiting in the wings. Oh, but I love you, and though I'm past 42, there are still a few things yet I didn't do. Baby, I will rock and roll with you if I have to.